former Plaz stepping into the referee shoes.
Absolutely. Well, they do say it's a huge advantage if you've played the game. You get an understanding, a feel for what's going on out there. So Russia in the blue strip against the red and white of France. And we're underway. This one going down the right-hand side. And first take for France is Laureline Fourcade. Pops it off to Biscarat, who's going to go right and wide. Chloe Pell. Little switch on the inside with Lipesque. And Lina Guerin hits the deck. Well, one of the best passes you're going to see this weekend, but France get away with it. Thomas. Flat pass. Was that forward? Referee on the spot and said it was. And an unforced error gives Russia a scrum deep inside the French half.
You can see what Thomas was trying to do there, giving that short ball to Biscarat. She was hoping for her to set up a ruck so they could reset and send the ball out wide again. They took it to the edge twice, France. It's good to see them with that kind of attitude of wanting to spread the ball.
So a scrum for Russia. Here's the feed taken by Maria Perestiek on her knees and a little interchange. But they've lost about 25 metres and brilliant blitz defence from France to push Russia all the way back towards the 10-metre line. Hamidova leaves it and the pass wasn't necessarily the worst I've ever seen, but certainly Daria Bobkova took her eyes off it.
Wowee, the attitude of the French defence, how's that? Not only the speed of the line, but how they're attacking that breakdown tackle area. Put pressure on the Russians, and that's why they made the mistake.
Biscarat goes to the line out. Thomas, ball off the top again. This one, did it go forwards? It did. And the French really their own worst enemies inside the first 2 minutes or so, because their mistakes just handing possession over to Russia. And you don't want to do that in sevens rugby. It's hard enough to get that ball.
Absolutely. Yeah, two errors, given possession away. But if they can keep this defensive system up, they can probably get back possession.
Trying to go blind. Thomas makes the tackle. And Mikhaltsova. Hamidova. Handoff attempt by Bobkova, but equally well tackled by Chloe Pell. France competing as they have done. And another turnover ball on the French defence. Brilliant defending so far. Can they put it together and attack? The answer is no. They're defending so well. Attack-wise, they're asleep at the wheel.
Look, I think Thomas... She knew there was an opportunity there. She looked up before she got the pass. Her brain was thinking, okay, this is it. You kick yourself when you do things like that, Hugh.
I kick you too when you do things like that, man. Perestiak. Little dummy thrown by Staromko and goes to go on the outside. Lira Garan has paced to catch her, but Staromko hits the deck in the pop pass. As far as Drakova, the speedster for Russia, but no room to show what she can do when she gets those legs going. France again, blitz defence. Look at that, straight up, swallowed in the tackle. Guerin eventually lets go, but France get the penalty. It's been a tale of Russian attack that's been pretty toothless, and then French defending in its absolute best so far.
Oh, wonderful. Great defence to see. And the way they stay on their feet at that tackle ball and they go for it, they've got all rights to it. And Russia just unable to get their support players here because they play quite individual. And so by the time someone gets there to help at that tackle ball, it's too late. France have stolen it.
So France, yeah, to fire a shot in anger. Can they get something going here? Go to the back and Thomas, good hands to hang on to that one. No problem this time with the French handling. As they're going to go wide here, looping past to Guerin. I spoke too soon. We went backwards though. Grassino picks it off the deck. Lina Guerin. Chloe Pell to Thomas. Two outsider. Flat pass, but again, it's another knock on. It's another unforced error. Advantage for Russia. They're going to try and capitalize here. Bobkova. Pass on the outside. Hamidova. Hamidova goes through the tackle. Hand off, and then she's going to reach for the line. Touches down. Well, France, you cannot get away with such poor handling time and time again. Hamidova capitalises for her 67th career seventh try.
Yes, finally the errors for France told. And Russia, you can't give them an opportunity like this, especially when they had Hamidova. See there, Chloe Pell overran on the outside. There was nobody outside Hamidova, so why run that way? She got stepped. So unfortunately, the first breach of that French defence was Hamidova. But of course, great work for Russia. Just being patient, biding their time, and so much strike power gave them the points.
So no joy with the conversion, but Russia strike first here, and France really too many handling errors. Top try score for Russia, 67 for Vaizet Hamidova. 90 seconds to go at the end of the first half. And France, any time they've had possession, they have just dropped the ball and handed it straight back to Russia. Can they get something here before the halftime whistle and level things up? They left it late last time, as we mentioned. Fourcade, tackled by Hamidova. Thomas. Grassino. Chloe Pell. Better. Guérin. Grassino once more. Any room in the middle for her? Thomas. One outsider. Fourcade. Screaming for the pass here on this near side. Biscara. Back to Fourcade. And there for Thomas. France at the halfway line. Inside the final minute of the first half here. Chloe Pell takes it from the sky. Lina Guérin, watched by Drakova. Tries to get the hands free. Drakova in, she's on her feet, but France have just enough numbers at the breakdown to recycle possession. There for Thomas. Fourcade. Fourcade with the handoff. Still going. Fourcade inside the 22. And eventually brought down. Just about our numbers there, but Russia managed to steal possession. Now they have two on the left-hand side. Drakova, we know how quick she is. Any room there? No, the pass to nobody. And France trying to pile through and turn over possession once more. Scrap at the breakdown. There goes the halftime hooter. Hamidova the try scorer. No way for her to get outside her 22. Chloe Pell decides to leave it.
Use it!
Both teams breathing pretty heavily. End-to-end stuff. Flat line. Bobkova. Tackled well. Still there for Russia. Little switch in the middle now. This is going to be a foot race back there. There is cover for France. Biscara is back there. And the offload is a good one. Can they get the pass away for Perestiek? They can't to Bobkova. He was thumped in the tackle by Jade Lepesque. Hamidova leaves it. Whistle's gone. Penalty. Illegal foot against the French coming in from the side.
Good scrambling defence, though, and they might have been penalised, but they stopped that attack in its tracks.
Hamidova, little chip and chase from her, but that one is a gift for French possession. And Thomas comes in from the wrong side to pick it off the ground. Another penalty to Russia inside the French 22. One try already, looking for a second.
Ooh, I tell you what, a lot of energy's been expended out on that field for just one try from both teams.
Thank you.
Yeah, there's a lot of tired bodies out there already. Still more defending to do for France here inside their own 22. Perestiek. Nice flat line, but equally good tackle came in from Chloe Pell. Hamidova, one outsider. Can she get the hand away? That looked like a decent hit to stopper on the 5 metre line. Drakova, desperate French defending. Russia testing those tackles with every pass. An advantage being played to Russia. Hamidova losing her strength at the line.
Held up. No advantage.
Going back for the penalty. Was held up just over the line.
Yeah, Chloe Bell there, the one underneath the ball from Hamidova. French defence holding out for now, but with Russia so close.
Perestiek, little switch. Guérin with the tackle, misses. Needs a bit of help from her teammates. Again, a counter-look from France is a good one. Russia on the ground there, can't play that ball. Referee says, on you go. Well, not for me. I mean, it looked like Hamidova was on the ground. Her knees were on the ground when she played that ball. Quick tap and go, Russia get the penalty.
Yeah, I agree with you. I do think that should have been French ball.
There's the tap. Chance for Russia. Almost at the line. Surely it's a try. Referee says yes. Well, slightly contentious that one, but it doesn't matter now. Russia have their second score of the game. And Mikhail Sova for her 16th try in her 7th career.
Well, this was all about direct play from Russia. They hadn't been spreading it wide whatsoever. They were asking for the short ball. Players hitting it hard. Holtzova was the one in the end who had enough power to drive through. When you're that close to the line, it's a really good tactic to have.
So conversion attempt by the try scorer to make it a 12-point lead. Struck it pretty well. Flag goes up. Bit of a fist pump as well. The Russians, 12 points to the good. Is it going to be enough, though? Because France had to come from 22 points down the last time, and they almost managed to do it. Half-time here is Russia 12, France 0.
Держать мяч как хотите. Умницы, все раки отбили, молодцы.
Давайте, девчонки, смотрите. Все здорово, контролируйте только мяч. Не паникуйте, встали. Медленно мяч в установку, чуть шире вставай. Очень плотно сбиваемся до штрафных, стянитесь, Ален. Силы переборите, они тоже устали, они тоже люди.
Да.
Пересильте себя, там минуту-две, и все получится. Быстрее сохраняйте раки, используйте чуть пошире.
Ребки, все получается, давайте.
Давай, 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 давай. Россия!
Точно так же,
Don't even know if that hat's real fur, you know.
Well, we'll give him the benefit of the doubt. You know, you turn up here with a Russian flag and the hat to match, you're going to get the benefit of the doubt.
Probably not PC to have a rabbit on your head anyway.
Well, I tell you what, he's a lot to smile about because Russia, two tries to the good. France yet to come into this game. They have had a history of being slow starters, though, so I wouldn't bet against them coming back. But if they do come back, they have to cut out those handling errors that we saw in the first half.
Yeah, I think it's a mindset thing with the French. I think their defence has been excellent, real high energy. But their mistakes have been on attack because they haven't switched their mindset to be not so frantic when they have the ball. I've seen some promising things in their pattern with keeping the width and going wide to wide, but they just need to relax when they're on attack.
Haven't seen too much of Elena Drakova at all in this game. And if she gets into a bit of space, it'll be interesting to see how France cope with her as Rose Thomas trying to lead the charge for France. 13th tournament in the Women's 7 Series, and it's going to be a line out to Russia. Podestiak to throw. Hamidova, the target, tallest player on the Russian team. She goes up for it. Toma loses out. Quick ball to use. Mikhalsova, nice chinking run. Almost offload there from Skoromko. And now we might get a chance to see how much gas she really has. Oh, Lina Garan watched her. And a beautiful tackle on Drakova. Mikhalsova to Hamidova. Hamidova gets the offload away. One-on-one on the outside here. France have numbers to come across. And again, Russia recycle and try and go again. Hamidova. Mikhalsova. Flat line and a direct punch up the middle attempt from Russia, but France again just defensively holding their line really well. Good communication. Drakova. Perestiak skips away from the first tackle, then gets the pass away. Was that one straight? It was, and it was okay, says the referee. France coming across to defend again. Huge amount of work by both teams. And the whistle goes, penalty to France for not releasing.
Yeah, once you call tackle, Russian attacker there needed to go to ground, create the ruck, hit the support play there. Gee, that was, once again, great scrambling defence for the French because it was this player here who was actually free on the outside, but somehow two French defenders made the ground, got over there. Here's another look.
Yeah, it was Bobkova just took one straight into the dirt there, didn't she? Aggressive French defending, as we see all the time. But That one straight into the ground, and Bob Kovac looks like just a bit of blood coming from her nose. She'll have to go and get that straightened out.
Okay.
And in comes Arina Bystrova to take her place. So France penalty, 5 minutes to go, two tries down. What do you got, France? Spiral kick into touch.
Bob Koba, of course, replaced by her twin sister, so I'm guessing
hold.
Pretty much the same kind of athlete.
Hold the ball, please. I have subs. Bring subs on, please.
So France getting ready to make a couple of changes of their own. Clémence Goussier and Elodie Goulion.
I can't understand the numbers, girls. Okay, can you two?
Lina Garin goes off.
Sorry.
Which means that Grassino goes out to the wing and Rose Thomas makes her way to the sideline as well. I'd like to see Grassino get a bit more ball in space. We know how good she is.
Oh, she's excellent. She's so fast. Love to see them go wide right now off this platform.
Ball off the top again from France to use. Good take that time from Goulion straight onto the pitch. Now we might see Grassino in a bit of space. Here she is. Little stop and a handoff. She goes. A pocket rocket. Drakova makes the hit. What an offload that was. Absolutely top class. Touches down. What a try for France. And the substitutes making the difference. But Grassino, what about the break? And what about the pass in to Jade Lopez for the try?
Jade Lopez right there giving the ball. No rights to get around the defender either, Glassino. Beautiful power and great support on that inside line. Drouard, that was excellent. The option was perfect. The passing crisp, right on the money. That's what the French team, we want to see more of.
Well, here we see it. Look at that from Glassino. And what about this for a pass, Mel?
It was great. Just a nice short line. You saw her change her line coming in where she knew the hole was. Lovely work.
12 points to 5. So France need a converted try just to draw level here. And look at the commitment there in the contact from Goulion, I think it was, who went up for that ball. No concern whatsoever for her own personal safety. Khamidova wasting no time getting on with it. And Russia looking to add another try. Look at the offload. Drakova now. Any room for her on the outside? Little check and stop. Back in. Decent tackle though from Clémence Goussier. As Russia keep it alive. Spun out wide. Courson trying to find Hamidova. Hamidova gets the hand and the pass away on the inside. Beautiful try. Fantastic Russian attack. And the French had no answer whatsoever to the pace of Kukila.
I think it's Hamidova in the middle of the field has been doing a lot of work for Russia. She's been their tower of strength. She injects, she makes ground, and she's so strong that she's able to release that ball in the tackle as well to Kukina, who basically just had to run off her shoulder and collect the points. What a great response from Russia.
Conversion attempt should be good from underneath the post. It is Russia, 19 points to 5. And the perfect response to France getting their opener is for Russia to strike back and put the gap at 14 points. Converted try twice for France now needed just to draw level. So Marina Kukina, the try scorer, to get us back underway. Beautiful support line, too much pace for France. And as you said, Hamidova is going to get a big hand for that one, because beautiful offload at just the right time. France now needs something, and they need something quickly. Nice heat from Sino. Another big tackle goes in from Russia and from Marina Petrova, the captain, forcing the knock on.
Hello, you've come off the bench.
Welcome to the game.
Sevens. Yep. It's that kind of defence that can win you games for sure. Outside in, wasn't it? She had no chance to see the defender coming in for that big hit.
Difficult pool this one. New Zealand, obviously, and Japan, the hosts, will be hoping for a good showing and fresh from qualifying for the series next year. Kicking clear. Mikhaltsova is going to get her second. Well, the French defence that was brilliant in that first half has just disappeared and evaporated, and Mikhaltsova takes full advantage.
Well, she's one of their star players, isn't she, Mikhaltsova? A great attacker, always involved. Her work rate's huge, both on attack and defence. Yes, it was weak defence. The key is lovely, straight line running. She hit it right on that advantage line, so difficult to defend. Miscommunication from the French. Russia looking strong to the end of this game.
Her second of the day, Elena Mikhaltsova, means that Russia cannot be caught. 26 points to 5. There is the full-time hooter. We've time for one more restart. But France well and truly beaten here in their opening game in Pool A. Russia restart. Poisson underneath it. Big physical powering presence for France. Gets the offload, but that one went forward. And it's been a tale of the tape for France, really. Handling errors all over the place. Russia taking advantage. Final score in the Pool A opener then.